Hey guys, it's Kevin. Do you have the ET-8550, the transportation log error, or the 40, so 0000, the 25 error that is tell you a paper jam? In the last video, I showed you this error is caused by this clear plastic tube guard. And fixing it is tedious because when you print, the printer just keep pulling this tube. Eventually, you're going to get that error again. In this video, I'm going to show you how to replace that flimsy piece of plastic with this drag chain tube guard. So your tubes will be rolling in style. We first released this long paper guard. Not only there are two screws underneath that we need to access, also this guard is holding the left side panel and the right side panel, so we have to remove this first. So you just open up a little bit, bend in the middle, and lift it up vertically. Each panel will have 3 to 4 both screws. For the right side panel, you can see there's a screw underneath the power socket, and there's a top screw that we just removed. And then underneath the ink tank, there's another screw. So it goes in like this. See the direction of the tab, so you're going to push towards the front to install and push towards back to uninstall. So we removed the screw underneath the power socket. I already removed the screw underneath that long piece, and then there's another screw on the ink tank. Push the panel towards back and that will be released. Okay, left panel, 4 screws, 2 in the front, bottom and top. The bottom one, you have to remove the paper tray to see it. In the back, there are also 2 screws. One is on the top, and another one is between the USB and the Cat5 cable holes. Now let's remove the front panels. There's 1 screw on the right bottom in the front, one on the top besides the tanks. Then you peel away from the bottom of the ink tanks. Then you can take the front panel off. Then we take this case off. I think there are 2 screws on the right. One underneath the waste tank and 1 screw on the left. Yeah, there are 2 screws. Now we go to bchtechnologies.com. We enter drag chain in the search. And we need this drag chain for ET-8550. This side with a long straight plat is going to the rail, and this side with hooks and is going to be attached to the printhead carriage. Now we need to take this cover off. See, this cover have 2 tabs, one on each side, and then there are 2 screw holes in the front. So we just unscrew the 2 screws in the front and lift up the tabs and remove the cover. And for the carriage lock, we removed the 2 screws. And we unplug all the tubes. And we can take it off. If you plan to reuse those tubes, it's a good idea. You have a Sharpie and mark the length of the tube. So when you install, you know how to install it back. And we removed the spring. You do not really need this part, but if you're a perfectionist like me, I need to install it back. So the whole thing is held by tabs. So basically, you just go around and lift all the tabs. You're going to find that once you lift some tabs, the other tabs are going to snap right back. And so what you can do is you go around one circle, just loose up the tabs. Then you, from one direction, you lift up the tabs and moving to the other direction, and make sure the one you like loosened before doesn't snap back. You're gonna see 2 white things fall off. Don't worry, just put aside and save it. I'm gonna cover that later. Now we're gonna remove everything from the tube. All those white holders and all those white clips on the rail, we're gonna remove them all. Then install the drag chain with a flat plate side first. The side that doesn't have the BCH wording towards the rail. For this client, he wants clear tubes instead of Epson OEM tubes. So you can skip this section. Go to bchtechnologies.com and search for this SKU. Make 2 orders of it because you'll need more than 3 feet. it comes in 8 strand, so you're going to tear off 2 strands. You only need 6 colors. It's easier if we remove this cover. So we remove one screw here and another screw hiding under those blue tabs. And another screw on the left. Then we take the cover off and remove the last screw. And this cover can be released. Remove one screw here. And this customer wants an external waste tank. So now is the best time to remove the waste tube. Now we pull off all the color tubes from the tank and remove the one screw underneath. For the set that connects to the tank, we separate the tubes into a single strand for about 1/2 feet, 6 inches. Then we use this black plate as a template. So we wire through all the strands. Okay, we just install the mold. Now we take a scissor and cut it even. So one by one, we insert the tube onto the tank. Put the tubes to your left and that will lower the plate. Again, you don't need to do this part if you use the Epson OEM tubes. However, this customer is going to use for DTF, so he wants to see inside the tube so he can detect if there's a clog in the tube. The good part is all the tubes together is a little bit easier than the OEM tubes to go through the drag chain. For OEM tubes, you have to pull the section by section to get through the drag chain. For this conversion, I'm still using the original Printhead. So for original Printhead, I usually just suck the ink into the tube, so make it a little bit easier for the printer to get the new ink supply. So I suck it almost to the end of the tube, then I insert back to the damper. Oh, the tool I used to suck the ink is just a regular syringe plus this adapter. So you can get it from bchtechnologies.com. Also, for the product I mentioned, I'm going to put a link about the printhead and the drag chain can be taken out separately, although it comes pre-assembled. But later, you might need to uninstall this printhead later, so I just make it detachable. This long hook is going to catch the bottom of the carriage. And then on the other side, you're going to see a screw hole. And secure that screw, and the whole thing is installed. You don't need the lock to be installed back. If you have a DTF printer, you probably just want to leave like this, or because you have the room here to install a secondary tank. If you select not install the lock, then there will be gap between the base and this top cover. And here I gave you a clear look. So you shouldn't screw all the way down. That will make the top end uneven and may even break it. Okay, now I show you how to install the lock back. Install the base. And you can massage the tubes into the groove. Okay, the white stuff. The white stuff, you're going to see a longer end and a shorter end. The longer end is on the side, so if on the left, the longer end will be on the left. And if it's on the right, flip it, the longer end is on the right. And so you put it in there. What that one is, it helps the lock to push down evenly so it can cut off the ink flow inside the tube. If you take a look of the blue lever, you're going to see it's half moon thing. So when you turn the half moon, push goes to the wrong side, push down, and that cut off the ink flow. It's only useful when you transport a printer. So if you do not install this, it's totally fine. And then you put a blue lever on, and remember it's all tabs, that black cover. Put it in there and put a spring back. But if you don't want much noise, you don't need to put this top cover back. However, if you do put the top cover back, you have to install that small cover on the left side. Otherwise, you can see the guard get caught here. So my suggestion is just forget it. Don't install the top cover at all. Okay, here's the noise level without cover. Here's noise level with cover on. Anyway, this is not going to print well because my plan with the client, they replaced the Printhead. It was a sublimation printer before, so the Printhead went bad. We're going to replace with a new Printhead. I'm testing on the old Printhead. Okay, so it's still going to print, but it'll be either nothing on paper or some garbage on paper. Okay. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.